All right, hello, welcome back. We are once again ready to rock and roll here. Another episode of Dev Play. Let's play Fallout 4 Survival Mode, pistols only. Although that's not necessary. Although that's not necessarily an actual rule that we're going to stick to, but for at least the majority of the game, it's going to be pistols.
What?
That's just the build that we are going with. It might be on, but you're dead, so... So, last episode, you might have heard me mention at some point that we were going to try to recover some footage that was lost. Unfortunately, I said I would edit it in. I went back and found out that the footage was corrupted because of the OBS crash. So, unfortunately, it was lost to history. Now, not a lot happened in that footage. All I did was go over and sell some stuff. There was a minor explosion that I didn't find the source of. I saw it on the horizon, went to check it out, couldn't find anything over at the diner. Everyone at the diner lived. I sold my shotgun shells. Everything was great. So, sorry if you were really excited to see that for some reason, but yeah, it's not gonna happen. I guess I'll take the pulse mine. I'll leave the other guns there. Really, I really want to travel light. Let's see, what am I in inventory at? Alright, let's see, what is our status? Peckish and parched, so we're just barely thirsty, just barely hungry, so let's just take care of both of those now. Ignore that. I forgot to close my email. Hopefully I don't get too many more of those. So purified water, and we'll just go with some... let's go for the cheap stuff. Radroach meat. Oh, that was uncooked radroach meat, damn it. Oh well. I don't know how cooking something removes the... Wow. I'll take that. So that's a nice little stimulus of fusion cores there. Let's see. Maybe we'll go with like a hardcore heavy weapons guy and just go all out in endurance and just be a giant brick tank, and we'll do like a second character like that at some point. That'll probably be my private character that I do like at night when I can't talk as much. Hopefully, soon, I'll be out of this living situation and living on my own again, where I can really just do this anytime I want, with a stable income and everything. If you guys don't know, I was working for a company. They weren't able to get their funding together. I wasn't able to stay on the project. So, since then, I've been basically between jobs. A little bit low on funds at the moment. But, all the YouTube money... It's definitely gonna save everything. No, that's a joke. I'm not gonna make any money off of YouTube. Well, I won't say ever, but certainly not anytime soon. I intend to make money off of YouTube, so it's not like a pledge to be like, oh, all the content free all the time, no advertisement, no monetization or anything. No, I'm gonna monetize it. I'm gonna do all that YouTube fun stuff. I want to get into like hardware reviews and things. We're gonna have to wait till I can afford some stuff, because they don't just give you stuff to review for like no reason whatsoever. You've got to go out and oh wait, that's a... we don't want to shoot him, we want to help him. Alright, who can we get here? There we go. Looks like we got them all. The guards are very helpful. I know that you take more damage and you deal more damage. I guess that the NPCs don't have increased damage to each other, because I'm noticing that in like these sort of firefights, earlier when we saw the two guys, the one thought the other was a synth and everything, that they were basically holding out really well against each other, and we were really, really the determining factor. And it wasn't just because, you know, we managed to shoot someone and upset the balance and it was like 3 shots kills. No, it was like they could have slugged it out for quite a while. Let's just canvas this building here, see what we can find. I don't want to know about that toilet. That's chained shut. Take some ammo. Metal leg. There we go. That'll help. We already got pipe guns. How are we doing on weight? 202 out of 260. Now, I don't think there's anything left to pick up until we get to Diamond City. But we're going to keep our options open. Let's make sure there's no mines over here. Oh, and there is. Anyone who's played the beginning of this game before has probably walked into this building and blown themselves up at least once. At least. This might be the first time I've played this part of the game and not blown myself up there. Cool. I have a fan.
Hey.
Looking for Diamond City? Just follow the signs.
Okay. So this will be good to note for our survival run. Is running around the near part of the city. It's got all this defense, so...
See those big lights? That's right. Working electricity.
Nice.
I got orders not to let you in, Miss Piper. I'm sorry. I'm just doing my job.
Ooh, just doing your job. Protecting Diamond City means keeping me out, is that it? Oh, look, it's the scary reporter.
I'm sorry, but Mayor McDonough's really steamed, Piper. Saying that article you wrote was all lies. The whole city's in a tizzy.
You open this gate right now, Danny Sullivan. I live here. You can't just lock me out. You want into Diamond City, right?
Just traveling through.
Shh. Way along. What's that? You said you're a trader up from Quincy? Do you have enough supplies to keep the general store stocked for a whole month? You hear that, Danny? You gonna open the gate and let us in, or are you gonna be the one talking to crazy Myrna about losing out on all the supply?
Jeez, all right. I need to make it personal, Piper. Give me a minute.
Better head inside quick before old Danny catches on to the bluff.
All right.
You first.
Ladies first. What the hell happened to me? That's gotta be some kind of bug. Look at that. My face is like... Okay. Maybe I'm a synth, and I just don't know it yet.
Piper, who let you back inside? I told Sullivan to keep that gate shut. You devious, rabble-rousing slanderer. The level of dishonesty in that paper of yours. I'll have that printer scrapped for parts.
Tyrant mayor shuts down the press. Why don't we ask the newcomer? You support the news? Because the mayor's threatening to throw free speech in the dumpster.
Always believed in freedom of the press.
Oh, I didn't mean to bring you into this argument, good sir. No. You look like Diamond City material. Welcome to the great green jewel of the Commonwealth. Safe, happy, a fine place to come. Spend your money. Settle down. Don't let this muckraker here tell you otherwise, all right?
This hasn't been the friendliest welcome.
Let's get you there, McDonough. Guess not everyone gets won over by that shark smile.
Now, was there anything particular you came to our city for?
Trying to find someone.
Trying to find someone? Who?
My son, Sean. He's less than a year old.
Wait.
And probably a synth, because I'm a synth.
You hear that,
apparently.
McDonough? What's Diamond City Security doing to help this man, huh? This isn't the first missing persons report to come through here, and now we have an infant who's been taken?
Now don't listen to her. Well, I'm afraid that our security team can't follow every case that comes through. I'm confident that you can find help here. Diamond City has every conceivable service known to man. One of our great citizens can surely find the time to help.
Well, sure. And a mayor of a great city must know everyone. Who can help me?
Well, there's one private citizen. Nick Valentine, a detective of sorts, who specializes in tracking people down, usually for debts or whatnot. No, I have to get going. I'm sorry, Diamond City Security doesn't have time to help, but I'm sure Mr. Valentine charges a reasonable fee.
This is ridiculous. Diamond City Security can't spare one officer to help? I want the truth, McDonough. What's the real reason security never investigates
me? I've had enough of this, Piper. From now on, consider you and that little sister of yours on notice.
Yeah, keep talking, McDonough. That's all you're good for. I'm impressed. Not everyone can claw information out of McDonough's tight-fisted hands. Why don't you stop by my office after you see Valentine? I think I just found my next story.
Alright, well, let's see.
Go inside. So, you're that traitor Piper was talking about. Something tells me she's pulled the wool over my eyes again. Alright?
I wasn't lying. I got a whole supply train coming in tomorrow.
Is that right? No bull?
Wow.
Well,
that was easy.
Let me put a down payment on some parts for the gate. Here you go. Anyway, welcome to Diamond City and all that. I gotta get back to work.
You're Sullivan, right?
So.
Excuse me.
Hey.
What is that? If you've played this game before, you know what I'm thinking. Let's see if a good old-fashioned loading screen fixes my face. Nope. Let's see if... Oh, wait, we can't do that. I was going to, like, exit and reload. Let's see if that fixes my face.
Hey, kiddo. How are the paper sales? Motor is going to go soon if we don't replace it. You've been saying that for weeks and the old girl still keeps cranking. Stop worrying so much. I gotta head into the office. You start whistling if you see any angry politicians coming our way.
Why? Is something wrong? Paper? Free paper to newcomers. If the Institute grabs you in the night, at least we warned you.
Free paper? Sounds like quality.
I'm serious. The Institute takes people. You should read up if you're sticking around.
Yeah, I am gonna believe her because I saw that guy trying to replace that other guy.
I believe you. Thanks.
You are a real lost lamb in the wolf's den, mister.
Anyone is one of those things, it's that secretary of his. Her and her perfect hair.
I hear there's a bar in the old theater district that's for raiders only. Combat zone.
Don't be content. Protection from Commonwealth weaponry.
Diamond City surplus. Everything you need.
Alright, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna go sleep it off and see if we can fix our face.
Newcomer, huh?
only one thing worth buying in a dugout in. That's the pools.
I think this is a hotel.
Crossing river, wearing nothing but a smile. When out comes,
you read the paper.
The most
dancing.
Miss?
Hi there. You can order drinks.
Meyerwerk!
A Meyerwerk!
Come on. That's like 2 out of 10 points of danger tops.
Let's see what you have.
Everything's cooked or brewed here.
Mm. Let me get some whiskey. I didn't mean to buy the vodka, but we do use vodka in a recipe, so let's see. Weapons? Yeah, you don't know. Maybe he'll rent us a room.
Custom. Need a room?
Yes.
All right.
Here.
You're in room 2. Just through the door.
There we go. Room 2. Let's see. Is this... Did that work? No. So let's exit the game. And just reload everything from scratch. Fallout 4, here we go. It's sinking. Sinking. Better, sort of. I mean, at least now I have a face. Not sure what the flickering's for. Alright, let's just...
See this bar? I killed a man for it. No, I kid. He is dead, though. Now, let me know when you're ready to order.
So, this your bar?
Damn straight it is. My brother Yefim and I make the best moonshine in the entire Commonwealth.
I can get behind some moonshine.
Best. Had to start renting out rooms just so customers had a place to safely pass out after drinking.
I'll think about it.
You know where to find me.
You there. We need to have a conversation.
Oh. Oh, let's hear it.
Let's hear it.
I'm always looking for people who know how to handle themselves in dangerous situations. From what I hear, you may fit the bill.
I don't mind danger, so long as I get paid well enough.
You'll get paid the starting rate, like everybody else. If you turn out to be as useful as you claim, then we can talk about a raise. By the way, I'm Edward Deegan. You'll mostly be working for me. But you'll need to talk to my boss first. His name is Jack Cabot. He likes to personally interview everyone I hire. He's careful like that. Come down to Cabot House in Beacon Hill and ask to talk to Jack. I'll let him know you're coming.
Yeah, cool. I've never gotten that quest before.
You ain't nobody. Got it? You ain't gonna last much
longer. Hey there. What's your story? Mercenary? Caravan guard?
I guess technically a mercenary at this point.
Blood, bullets, and money. All the way.
Right. right? Well, maybe not so much the blood part if you can help it, but I hear you. Anyway, I'm just kicking back and sharing stories while I'm between things. I've been all over, seen vaults, pre-war ruins, and plenty of monsters.
You've been to a vault?
Yeah. Ever heard of Vault 81? Standoffish, but every once in a while, they'll let new people in.
Let's hear your best monster story.
I'm from Diamond City. You want to talk something really scary? It's the Institute of Sense. Don't go to University Point. Trust me. You don't want to know what they're capable of.
See you around, Hawthorne.
Later.
Hey, Hawthorne.
Come for more of my wisdom? Here's one. Fabled treasure at the top of the old high-rise? Never worthy.
So you explore old ruins?
Last place I was going to check out was Salem. Real old town far to the north. Never made it, though. Got a bad feeling about that area.
Okay. Well, those are some little things, I guess. Alright.
Hey.
Look, Scout. I ain't buying anything.
Alright, resident.
Whatever you want.
That's all we're gonna get out of here. Let's go hunt for some more quests outside. See what we can drum up. See if we can get some business going.
Oh, no. Whatever it is, keep it to yourself.
Officer?
Word of advice. Never call your mother a simp unless you need it.
That's not good.
Jack, what if I told you about keeping the lake clean? Don't make me shut down this little stand of yours.
Mere fruit.
It's a health hazard, Chang.
It's a profit hazard, is what I say. I manage the water, and I'll do it without your interference. Thank you very much.
No funny business.
Hey there, purified water. You won't find this out on the Commonwealth.
You by yourself out here?
That's oh god, my face.
I've been on my own since I was 8. I'm a fully independent man. Got my own place. Go to night classes. The whole shebang. I get you a bottle of water, huh?
Anything I can do to help out?
The industrious type. Wanna help me clean out the water supply? You won't believe the junk people throw in there. What promotes the filters?
Depends. What's this worth to you?
Job's 100 caps. I like you. 125.
What kind of stuff is down there?
You're looking for big things. Anything around the size of a book, usually.
Come on, my time's worth more than that.
150.
I'm on it.
Just don't drown.
Not gonna push my luck.
Never clean your carcass out of there. Fresh water! Come on, people! I ain't standing here for my health.
1. Oh, goodness. I wish the water was a little more transparent. It would make this a lot less irritating. There's 2. I wonder if there's like more than 5 things. Ooh, a skull. Well, 3, 4. Okay, we need some right away. We need to get out. We shouldn't have even done that. Let's just go to the doctor and get healed up. I'm getting a lot of like foggy weather conditions. I wonder if the weather is more foggy, more rainy and stuff in survival mode.
What have you done with the real Riley? Where's my brother?
I swear, I'm not a simp. Don't shoot, for God's sakes, we're family! Kyle, no!
Okay, show's over. There are no simps in Diamond City, hear me? Just you folks and your damn paranoia.
At least someone in this town did more than just stand and gawk.
Nice shot. I'm gonna have to ask you to step back. Got a mess to clean up.
Hey.
My own brother. If you hadn't shown up, He would have killed me.
Hey, we could be related. You know, other than the fact that my face is apparently a digital projection, but...
You're safe now. That's all that matters.
I'm not a Sith. I told him. I kept telling him. Why didn't he listen to me? I need him.
Thanks for the help. But I got a mess to deal with. Get going. I understand, officer. I just want to know what happened.
What, you didn't hear the shouting? Guy pulls a gun on his own brother, thinking he's a synth. It's that newspaper's fault. Got people all riled up, thinking their own family might be replaced by machines.
Look, I'm sorry you got caught up in all this, but it's over, okay? Just go about your business like nothing happened. Better that way.
What's everyone still standing around for? Go back to your own damn business.
Move along.
Hi.
Around here, we call your haircut the scab special.
Talk some sense into
blood,
my net-worth son.
You should think about
I got a secretary. Is she a simp?
No idea.
You don't know? What? Born without a brain between your ears?
You just said that no one can tell the difference, Mom. He don't know if Geneva's a sin, and neither do you. So could you lay off?
Don't you talk to your mother that way, Johnny.
Hey, Kathy.
You want a haircut? Talk to
John.
Johnny.
For your hair, I'm thinking highlights. Or we could try a short shave on the sides. Or maybe some braids.
Not right now.
Sure, some other time.
Hey, John.
Snip, snip, and bam.
Let's see if he has any work for us. Let's see.
What are my options?
You name it. Shaves, long cuts, short cuts, braids, layering. Yeah, be easier just to show you. Got an empty chair right here.
Let me think it over.
Hey, no rush.
All right.
Doctor?
Patient. A new file from Hope. You have a legitimate medical concern. Is this about a facial reconstructive services?
Yeah. See what's wrong with me, Doctor.
What's feeling off today? What can you tell me?
Took a few bad hits recently. Got knocked around.
Severe lacerations, puncture wounds, muscle spasms in the eyes from high levels of stress. Let's patch you up.
Ha! Sounds like I'm in rough shape.
Anything else bothering you?
Too much radiation.
Blood pooling in the gums. Signs of anemia. Yeah. We better clean you up. Done. Now, was there anything else bothering you?
Nope.
That was it.
All right. Don't ruin my hard work by dying out there.
Hey, Doc.
Let's get you examined right away. Time is not on the side of the surgeon.
Not right now.
Let me know if that changes.
How's my face doing? Still really, really questionable.
Hey, man. Got a lot of chems here if you need something to help you relax.
Looking for a job, if you got one.
Yeah, I got something. Looking for a mutated bird, if you find it.
Why is it just
here's
my face?
Out near Forest Grove Marsh. Natural radiation sucker. Be great for cooking Rad X and Rad away.
Yeah.
Sweeten the deal with some money, and I might be interested.
You strong-arming me? Hey. 100 caps, that's all you get.
Mutated firm. Sounds good.
Cool.
Hey, Solomon.
Got chems right here for you, brother.
Did you say something about drugs?
That's right. All the chems you need to fill out your lifestyle. Balance, yeah. Everyone here buys from me. Sometimes security needs a little psycho, or an engineer needs some mentats. Heck. Rad X is plain universal.
Not today.
Cool.
I really want my face to stop being ridiculous. Oh, why did I even try that?
We got small arms.
You okay?
So thirsty. Doctor says I can't drink liquor no more. Cola. Need a new Coca-Cola.
Sure.
Get a drink. New Coca-Cola.
Here you go.
Ah, oh, thank you. Thank you.
Hey, Sheffield. What do you think about coming to work for me?
Really? You mean it?
That's right.
We'll send him to the drive-in.
Okay, I'll do it.
Hey,
you're the new guy, right?
The new guy?
Word kind of travels fast in Diamond City. What can I say? Name's Arturo Rodriguez. If you need protection, let's talk.
So you know weapons, huh?
Listen, I can sell you guns, swords, whatever. And they'll keep you alive for sure. But the real secret is in the mods. The little personal touches. Install a scope, expand the clip size, whatever. You spend time with your gear, and you'll have the right answer to every problem. Anyway, let's get back to you and what kind of protection you need.
Just browsing for now.
Hey, no rush.
Yeah, I'll deal with him in a little bit. Let's see what she's got.
You buy and sell everything to everyone, except sense. No sense allowed here.
Hey there.
You? I don't know you. Just keep your distance.
One Statue of David impression coming up.
Good. Good. Now just answer me one simple question. Are you human? Because I will not serve a synth.
Human as the day I was born.
Well, you do look human enough. And I'll be watching you. I have eyes like a... Well, they're good eyes. Got it? All right. We can do business, but no funny stuff.
What kind of business you running here, anyway?
We buy and sell anything and everything. 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. The robot takes care of customers at night. Only one I trust to do it. At least I know he's a machine.
Let me think it over.
Of course. Hello. Have you been here before?
Nope. First time.
Thought so. Some ground rules. This isn't a charity. Clothes are for sale if you have the money. Otherwise, the door's right there.
You have some kind of problem with shoplifters?
Nothing me and my 10-gauge haven't been able to handle. Now that we understand each other, welcome to Fallon's. Happy to show you everything in stock.
Fallon's Basement. Interesting name.
Yeah, it's ancient. There was a Fallon's here back even before the war. Granddad always said we had a tradition of quality and affordability. Guess affordability got too expensive for some folks. Damn thieves. And it ain't like Diamond City Security helps.
Why doesn't Diamond City Security help you?
My husband got taken, all right? By the Institute. Security wouldn't look into it. I raised a stink, and now I'm blacklisted.
Your husband was taken by the Institute?
Well, he ain't here anymore, that's for sure. Not like the Institute leaves a trail besides those damn synths.
What's a synth?
You're joking, right? A synth. Those machine people the Institute builds. Some of them even look human. Enough you wouldn't know the difference. Lucky me, huh? The Institute takes my Charlie and doesn't even bother replacing him.
What do you know about synths?
Just what I read in the papers. That the Institute builds them, and some even look human. So much you can't tell the real difference. Lucky me, huh? Institute takes my Charlie, doesn't even bother replacing him.
I'll think about it.
You know, she wears the cool sunglasses.
Need a new set of clothes?
I've got a few minutes to browse.
A paying customer. Finally.
Finally. That would look good on me. I feel like that's not gonna work out. Like, that's gonna go... You know what, we'll buy it just in case. Blue suit, dirty black suit. Go with a dirty black suit. For our charisma. We might as well try a few things out. It's not like they're expensive. Oh, we don't need a dress. There we go. Anything we need here? Not really. Anything we need here? Cloth, leather, no. Definitely no. And then what can we sell? Anything? Weapons. We can sell that. We want to preserve what we have. We're going to sell the t-shirt and slacks. I feel like the dirty black suit is more our style. Kind of get that, like, a tombstone look, if you know what I'm talking about. And we're just gonna sell a bunch of this stuff, because this is actually a real pain to track all this. I feel like this is gonna be useful. I haven't read that. Don't care. Whoop, subway token. I don't want to sell the subway token. I don't know if it's useful, but it seems like the kind of thing you want to collect. You know what, and this might get us into that racetrack, so I'm gonna hold on to that too. Junk, let's see. Ammo. Oh, right. There we go. I don't know if I found all those or if I actually had to load the game after I died before. If I died after I tried to sell them in the missing footage, so. Alright, let's see what we got. Alright, inventory. Okay, so that goes on. I really like that, but... Jeez, my face. I'm gonna reload as soon as possible. Yeah, that looks good for us. I like that. For the charisma, anyway. But this makes me sad. I really wish I could use that. See, and then same with this. This goes on over everything. Looks good. Whoops. Okay, so... Yep, we missed something. There we go. Looking pretty good. Other than the whole neck thing. If I like the patrolman sunglasses better, or if I like the regular glasses better. Well, we'll talk to them again. Save the game again. See if we can't sort out our face.
Oh, here we go.
Quiet, you. All right. Help. Diamond City Radio. It's terrible, yes? Makes you want to cut your own ears off.
No, I don't think I noticed.
You listen to me. It grates on ears like sandpaper. This DJ Travis, he is disaster. Something must be done, and soon. We will have customers suiciding before long.
Damn.
It's true. Don't listen to my brother. Someone needs to get rid of him. We need a new DJ for the radio. I don't think many would notice if he, you know, disappeared.
Are you serious?
Did we not just agree this is serious problem? Calls for serious solution. First, you get him to follow you out of town.
Ah, right. That's enough. Him isn't serious. He doesn't really want to kill Travis.
Okay, what's really going on here?
Sorry, I was just joking around a bit.
It's true. Only jokes. Travis is a good friend. Yefim and I worry about him.
Well, Travis, he means well, but he does not have the confidence he needs for that job or anything else. And so he's always awkward. He does not believe in himself, you see? He expects he will fail everything, and so he does.
Well, that can always be turned around.
Exactly. This is what I'm telling you here. Go on, spoil sport. Go back to working. We'll figure out how to help Travis. Come, you. Meet me in back room. We discuss plan.
Looks good. I ain't buying anything.
Right. Anyway.
Drinks!
Yes, drinks.
What do you want, Vadim?
I am glad you are willing to come. Unlike my deadbeat brother, Travis is a good guy. He deserves a better life.
I haven't agreed to anything yet. Let's not go patting ourselves on the back.
Okay, okay. But listen, Travis would get great confidence from winning bar fight, yes? You've been in fair share of them, I can tell.
I can hold my own, if that's what you mean.
Exactly what I mean. I want you to back up Travis in his first fight. I want to stage fight here in Dunham. Nothing too serious. We make sure Travis wins and feels good about himself after. I want you to be there to help make it look real. What do you think? Sound good to you?
I'm on board. When do we start?
Why not soon as possible? I have contacts, people I can count on. Real tough looking. But they will take a dive for money. They confront Travis here at Dunwood. You step in and give him push he needs to stand up to them. Then you and Travis take them down. Nothing gets too rough. And Travis is something he can feel good about. Simple, right? It's too late today for me to arrange. You come back tomorrow evening after 6 o'clock and everything will be ready.
Alright, let's see. What time is it now, anyway? It's 6:30 now. Let's see. Alright, well.
Just don't throw up all over my floors.
Eat some food. Whoops, I didn't mean to. Oh well. Alright, we'll sleep for 12 hours and start the bar fight. Get a real good night's rest. Oh, it'll be 6 a.m., so that won't really help us, will it? Whoops. Well, what we can do, though, is reload our game. Let's just try this reload. See if this does it. If not, then we'll quit the desktop again and see if that does it. I don't know what causes this, though. It seems really arbitrary. See, like, now we're just fine. So... it's another 3 hours till store's open.
Hey, you fiend.
Have a nice day.
Okay, well... now the store should be open. Inventory... aid... let's eat some junk food. Properly fed. Properly hydrated. There we go.
Just don't throw up all over my floors.
Good to see returning customers. Most
come time. On.
You let me know if you need a drink.
There we go. We have escaped the bar narrowly with our lives. Let's see if we can, what else can we do? What else can we do?
Don't talk to me. Might attract someone's attention.
Hey, scabber. Got plenty of Brahmin meat on the hooks.
Wait, what kind of meat is this?
You never heard of Brahmin? Big, dumb, got four legs and two heads. The only cattle around. Everything's fresh from the Codman family farms. Sometimes, you get weird stuff. Caravans, too.
Weird stuff? Weirder than two-headed cow meat?
Yeah, Prince Charming. Weirder than that. Mirelurk, bloatflies, rad stags. It's all protein, right? Ain't like you can be picky in the common
world. Well, there's some truth to that.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Remember, bloodier is better.
Let's see. What if we just bought everything she has? How much did that cost us? I know we already have like too much aid already. What can we get rid of? Let's see. What do I really not need? I don't need... I want stuff I can cook, not stuff that's already... don't need that, we don't need that. There we go. Yeah, we'll take some stuff like this. Okay. Speaking of cooking... let's... let's roast it up. It's free experience, and the food's good.
You've been to Good Neighbor?
You know, I don't have any reason to believe there's a quest in the schoolhouse, but you never know.
Mr. Suwiki, we had a pop quiz yesterday.
And we've learned a lot since then, so we're going to reinforce that knowledge with a little quiz.
But I'm tired.
I'm detecting a high degree of fatigue in all our little scholars. Perhaps the quiz can wait?
All right,
oh,
you guys.
Wow, you're tall.
We'll do the quiz.
Yes! Yay! Do you know that radiation is why Brahmin have two heads? It's true.
Ah, a new scholar come to join us. Let's test your math skills. What is 12 times 15?
Is it 180?
That's right. I see your parents raise you with a respect for your education. Family. It is important, yes? This thing called love. I hear the children talk about. I think they need that to learn.
Let's see, what would I answer? I'm a tough Western guy. I guess he'll go with,
Love won't keep your family alive. Sometimes, you need to be hard.
Oh, I see. I have one more question before you leave. It's not another quiz. I don't get to talk to many adults. This love I hear about, do you think you can have it for someone, even if the two of you are very, very different?
Well...
Who are you talking about?
Get right to the point.
Just imagine one is tall and handsome and smart, and one is gentle but a bit metallic.
If you love someone, hold on to them. Tomorrow you might not have the chance.
I thank you. You have helped me make up my mind about something.
No, I think I got it. That's what my friend
Edna.
Shane told me.
Mr. Zwicky is the teacher here. Isn't he wonderful?
Hey there.
Knowledgeable?
Sorry, you're in the wrong place. This is a school, not a store.
A school?
I think he gets threatened or apologize.
Diamond City gets a free education.
Kind of want to threaten him just to see what he says.
If they have busy day schedules. I'm afraid you're a little old to be enrolling here. Doubt you'd fit in the seats, but it's a public building, so feel free to look around. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to get back to my lesson plans.
Mr. Zwicky,
isn't it?
I'm quite busy.
I'm thinking to go on field trips. Feel free to look around. Who's a second head? And they start arguing with each other.
Let's see, where else can we go? We've been to Fallon's basement. We've been here. We've gone to the meat shack.
Nothing to see here.
I know the robot doesn't give us any quests.
Yo there! You need a genuine, authentic, custom-made hickory swat.
What's a swatter?
Rookie, eh? Swatter, my friend, is a Diamond City tradition. See, it used to be that this whole place was a stadium. And two teams would meet and play a game called baseball. One team would beat the other team to death with these things called baseball bats. And the best bats were called swatters. True fact.
Look, dumbass, that's not how baseball was played.
Don't have to be so mean about it.
Yeah, if you're such an expert, how do you think it was played?
We're gonna go with the American. I like the more violent.
It was America's pastime. A sport that united families on warm summer days. And it wasn't violent. Mostly.
I like my version better. Now, can I interest you in these genuine, authentic, custom-made hickory swatters?
Don't need anything today.
Yep.
Hey, Mo?
Need a swatter with a little more stopping power? Stainless steel nails, my friend.
Got any work?
Well, if you want to help the sport, I got a lead on a stash of pre-war collector's items. Coach, quitting is for punks. Weston had an estate not too far from here. Legend says when he retired, the league presented him with a baseball, catcher's mitt, and playing card signed by all the other coaches. See where I'm going with this? I'll pay 100 caps each for those relics. What do you say?
100 caps seems light. I need more.
I like your moxie. We'll make it 125 caps apiece. How's that sound?
Please. You own a whole store. You can do better.
Look at that fire in your eyes. All right. 150 caps for each piece. Better be worth it. Deal.
A card, a mitt, and a ball. Got it.
I thank you. And baseball thanks you.
All right. I don't think there's anything in security, but we'll go check it out.
Jeez, pal. I like guns too. Think you might be overcompensating there?
Overcompensating? All I got's a pistol.
Officer?
You're getting pretty chummy with that report, huh? Be careful. You're heading outside the wall. I want to stock up and Commonwealth weapons first.
Hey, officer.
You read that article?
Word is something bad down the old museum.
Officer?
You look a little roughed up. You should talk to Doc Crocker over at the Mega Surgery Center.
What? I am not roughed up. This is like the evidence locker. Yeah, there's nothing in here for us. At least nothing worth, not... You know, unless we're gonna steal some things, then there's some stuff in there for us, but no.
Touch the paint.
Make me.
What? Why?
This is the wall. The great green guardian that keeps out the bad guys. No one's broken through the wall. Never. Least we can do for her in return is keep her looking pristine. Thinking you need a little education. Maybe a bit of community service. What do you say?
Happy to help out.
You see this paint I'm using? Only one place left in the whole Commonwealth you can get it. Hardware Town. Rune store close by to the west. Bring back a can of paint, and it'll be 100 caps in your pocket. How's that sound?
Only if you throw in some more money.
Fine. Pay you 125 caps.
I think you can do better than that.
Having a hard bargain, huh? 150 caps.
What can you tell me about it?
Raiders moved in a ways back. Security says they can't handle it. That's why I'm running low. So, you still up for it?
Paint retrieval. I'm on it.
Much obliged.
Stories to drive us apart. We will not betray this sacred trust. Now, I want everyone to hear these next words. Very carefully.
Excuse me.
I am not a synth. I am the same flesh and blood boy who grew up on these streets. He was born in a shack just down the waterfront to Butler and Patrick McDonough. And I will not abandon my city due to the heinous allegations.
I can't hear the speech anymore. Hopefully he doesn't start over again. He's done. Good. Okay. Let's see if we can...
Mayor McDonough?
But I'm very busy right now. I have somewhere to be. Sorry.
Keep walking.
Let's see, that's housing.
No money business.
MIKEA cares about you. All
the latest hairstyles from the upper stage.
The hub of trade for all Diamond City right here.
We got small arm, long arm, and fish jugs.
Does anyone fight back? Institute has to have enemies, right?
You need a haircut. The John is super superior.
Something wrong?
His ties. Oh, Nick. Another stray coming in from the rain.
It's not raining.
Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
I know you must be busy, but I won't take much of your time, Miss. It's important.
You're right. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be rude, but it's just... the detective... has gone missing.
Don't worry. I can help. Tell me what happened.
Nick was working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station. There's an old vault down there that they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but... he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does.
Hey, I'd love to help, but there's a small matter of expenses.
Money, huh? I do have $120.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Who's this Skinny Malone character?
I don't know much about him, but he's from Good Neighbor, and that means he's in the well-pressed suits and machine gun school of thuggery.
Come on, this is your boss's life we're talking about here.
Don't play games with me. I'll pay you if you find Nick, but it's going to be 100 cabs.
That's the reward. We failed.
It's not up for negotiation.
You said Malone's from Good Neighbor?
Yeah, it's a tough neighborhood. Northeast a ways. People with power there care about two things. Style and body count.
I'll find him. You have my word.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to spot. He's always wearing that old hat and trench coat getup. Please, hurry.
Alright, we gotta find him. There's some interesting stuff in here to pick up.
Yes.
Let's see, what else can we do? I swear you could go in one of these buildings here at some point. What's that? Marino's house?
Don't be caught dead! Protection from Commonwealth weaponry!
Don't let down the home team!
There you go, greenhouse. There's no one in here. I thought there would have been like a... oh, whatever. I guess we'll head up to the mayor's office and then figure out exactly what we're doing.
Are you sure about this? I am not a normal girl.
My dear, you're perfect. I only wish I had realized that sooner.
And by the power invested in me, I pronounce you man and wife.
Make a very big decision.
Pastor.
Thank you.
Been a while since we had a wedding.
I know what this love
man
is now.
And a robot. Strange. But I don't think God will mind.
This super salon can give you
Edna.
So happy.
These years, I never realized how much she meant to me until she said something.
You read that article? Public appearances?
I'm so
damn sense could be anywhere.
Okay, then. I also never realized that this was a church, supposedly.
Good to see someone new in the chapel. Diamond City treating you all right?
Well enough.
For your sake, I hope things aren't always just well enough. We take pride in making things a little better each day. Could be the same for you. Now, if you ever need a quiet place to sit down and ponder the Almighty in whatever form strikes your fancy, we're always open.
So, you don't practice any particular religion here?
As long as you believe in something, you're welcome. Diamond City is full of people trying to build a better life. I just don't want them to forget what makes them human while they're at it. So, the chapel is open 24 hours a day. To whatever form of worship you like, long as it's peaceful.
Thanks, Master.
Feel free to make yourself at home.
Interesting.
You should really talk to the pastor.
First time. Just try and keep it down.
Hi.
You should really talk to the pastor.
Hey, Clements.
We're always open. Anytime you need to sit and talk to whoever you think is up there.
I'm a little upset that there's not a quest in there, but it's interesting that it exists. Also surprised they didn't mention the Children of Adam, which were in Fallout 3.
You can't stop the press.
Nah.
Watch your back. Institute could be right behind you.
What? Nope. No, just the church. And that bird. Unless it's an Institute bird. It's dead now. Alright, let's see what's in public occurrences.
Glad you dropped by. You holding up, Blue?
Why are you calling me?
Because you're a vault dweller? I know you're not wearing a blue jumpsuit right now, but the Pip-Boy and the fish out of water look. Dead giveaways. So here's the deal. I want an interview. Your life story in print. City had a little outside perspective on the Commonwealth. You do that, and I'll tell you what. I'll come with you. Watch your back while you...
I don't need you to come with me. But I'll still do the interview.
I'm in.
Good. Let's get down to business. So, I know you're from a vault. How would you describe your time on the inside?
My family and I were frozen. I didn't spend much time.
Wait, they boxed you up in a fridge? The whole time? Are you saying you were alive before the war?
Yes. I'm over 200 years old.
Oh my god. The man out of time. So, you've seen the Commonwealth, Diamond City. How does it compare to your old life?
World out here, it's not even close to the one I left.
Feeling a little homesick, are we? Can't say I blame you. Now, I already know you're looking for your son, Sean. Do you suspect the Institute was involved in his kidnapping?
Sure sounds like they might be.
Not even a baby is safe from them. And people wonder why I can't just look the other way. For the last part of our interview, I'd like to do something different. I want you to make a statement to Diamond City directly. The threat of kidnapping is all but ignored in the Commonwealth. Everyone wants to pretend it just doesn't happen. What would you say to someone out there who's lost a loved one but might be too scared or too numb to the world to look for them?
No matter how much you want to give up, don't. You have to have hope that you'll see them again. Or at least, that you'll know the truth.
A strong note to end on, Blue. That's everything. It's gonna take some time to put this all together, but I think your story is gonna get Diamond City plenty to talk about. Anyway, I agreed to come with you, right? Watch your back. Just say the word when you're ready. I can't wait to see where the story goes next.
Piper.
Heading my way?
Sure, let's go.
Will do.
Let's send her.
Hey.
What you got for me? Cap for your thoughts?
It's time we part ways.
Sure thing. I'll head home.
To the drive-in.
Let me know if there's anything I can do to let
you
go.
And with that, everything... Everything we've got here is now ours, basically. We'll leave her stuff alone. Nope, I didn't want to do that. Wow. Bunch of missiles in a box. And I think we're over encumbered. Let's see if we can take care of that. I mean, we don't use missiles, so we can sell the missiles and we can sell the mini nuke. I'll probably regret that later, but yeah. You know, if we can get
don't
over to the guy.
The wall undefended. High quality protection for sale.
Probably not. Some guy came into town. So he picked up a distress call on the king.
Arturo.
We can talk about guns, or maybe you want to consider.
Let's see what you got.
Everything hand tool.
I guess we stored the mini nuke, which is, I guess, fine with me.
And they sell just about everything, but none of it is.
What time is it? Oh, we've gained a level at some point. Oh, yeah, now we can build workshops. That's what we needed. And then, oh, we've gained 2 levels. Well, now that we can craft. Well, we didn't gain 2 levels, it's just showing us. Whoops. Alright, well, here's what we gotta do. Well, alright, we've had enough time for this episode, so I'm gonna consider this episode over. I'm gonna pause it, it'll save, and then I'm gonna resume. So just give me one moment and I'll be right back. But if you're watching this on YouTube, this is the end. I look forward to the next episode, and I'll see you there.